This is a Russian decapod. I'm Darren, and this is the Industrial Revolution. Built in 1918, this 2100 steam locomotive was built to work in Russia. However, after the Bolshevik Revolution, the Russians canceled their orders. At that point, there were about 200 of these in production, in process, and Russia didn't take any of them. That left the U.S. with 200 spare locomotives that we couldn't run on our tracks. And there's good reason for that. This generally looks like a pretty conventional steam locomotive, and it is. It's a little big. The 10 driver wheels are a bit problematic for sharper turns. However, it still works, and several different locomotive designs were made with the 10 drivers. Let's take a look at the odd part here. Look at the actual drivers. Russia ran a 5-foot gauge compared to the U.S. gauge, which was, and still is, 4 feet, 8.5 inches. Look how far these wheels hang off over the side of the rail. Well, when the Russians canceled the order, they had all these locomotives that were in process. And really the only big difference is the wheels. They're designed for a 5-foot gauge instead of US standard gauge. So what they did is they replaced the leading wheels, they replaced the tender wheels, replacing the drivers with more complex. You've got all these connecting rods, the pistons, everything up here that would have had to be moved. The connection points are in the wrong place and everything for a 5-foot gauge. So instead of that, they actually just placed these really wide wheels on here for the drivers. And by doing that, they were able to change it so that it would work on standard gauge. It looks a little funny. You have an extra 1¾ inch sticking out on the side of each of your drivers. But it works just fine, and it means you didn't have to change your connecting rods, you didn't have to change where your pistons are, you didn't have to change all your steam lines, and you can put these on U.S. rail lines and run them pretty much right away. So that's what they did. And I said there were about 200 of these that ended up, as a result of the Bolshevik Revolution, ended up not being wanted by the Russians anymore, and they all ended up on U.S. rail lines. So after this locomotive was re-gauged, it went to the Pennsylvania Railroad. It was later sold to the St. Louis and San Francisco Railroad. It was signed for mixed traffic, mixed freight and passenger traffic. It was retired in 1950s as a result of the dieselization of the fleet and the elimination of steam locomotives. It was sold to Eagle Pitcher, where it hauled lead ore for a while, until 1961, when it was donated here to the National Museum of Transportation in St. Louis, Missouri. So they had to change the gauge on this locomotive, but that's not the first time that locomotive companies, railroad companies, had to change gauge. Following the Civil War and the problems with the Civil War, with different gauge railroads all over the country, most railroads ended up changing gauges as a result of federal law. So the federal law established a standard 4-foot, 8.5-inch gauge for all U.S. railroads. Most of the world is running that gauge right now. Russia does still run a 5-foot gauge, and there are narrow gauge here and there. It's still more useful if you're on a very tight tracks in mountains and mines, things like that, specialty railroads. So this Russian decapod, instead of being scrapped, through some creative regauging, was put to use. And as a result, it served a long life and today is available here in this museum. Trains like this are the Industrial Revolution. Anyway, I do need your help to keep this channel going. If you've enjoyed the video, please hit like and subscribe. Also, I do have a Patreon page over at patreon.com/industrialrevolution if you get help out there. This channel obviously involves a lot of travel to come out and see stuff like this. So if you could help me out, I'd appreciate that. Membership starts at just a few bucks a month.